The bishop now entrusted the minister custos of the Order of Fathers Minor, Reverend Father Felix Hongo OFM, the documents and the key to the door of the chapel, who in turn gives to Father Jaime Raul Yakit OFM, the guardian of the priory. Please all rise upon the holy gospel.
The Samaritan woman said to Jesus, "Sir, I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshiped on this mountain, but you people say that the place to worship is in Jerusalem." Jesus said to her, "Believe me, woman, the hour is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You people worship what we do not understand. We worship what we understand, because salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming and is now here, when your worshippers will worship the Father in the spirit and truth. And indeed the Father seeks such people to worship Him. God is spirit, and those who worship Him must worship in spirit and truth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated, and let us now recess with the homily of Most Reverend John Forrosuelo, who will be here.
Nevertheless, in accordance with the tradition of the Church in both East and West,
a special prayer of dedication is also said. This prayer is a sign of the intention to dedicate the Church to the Lord for all times and a petition for His blessing. Please rise and let us prepare ourselves.
Let our prayer go forth to God the Father through Jesus Christ, His Son, with whom I join all the saints who have shared in His suffering and are seated to this table of glory.
Let us all meet.
Christ have mercy.
prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary and of all the saints make our prayers acceptable to you. May this chapel, which we dedicate to your name, be a house of salvation and grace, where Christians gather in fellowship, may worship your spirit and in truth, and grow together in love. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please hold fast. The relic now being posted and locked in a compartment at the altar is a relic of St. Anthony of Padua, to whom this house of prayer is dedicated.
Father in heaven, source of holiness and true purpose, it is right that we praise and glorify your name. For today we come before you to dedicate to your lasting service this house of prayer, this temple of worship, this moment in which we are nourished by your word and your sacraments. Here is reflected the mystery of the church. The church is fruitful, made holy by the blood of Christ. A bride made radiant with his glory, a virgin splendid in the fullness of her faith, a mother blessed through the power of the Spirit. The church is holy, your chosen vineyard, his branches envelop the world, his tendrils carried on the tree of the cross, raised up to the kingdom of heaven. The church is favored, the dwelling place of God on earth, a temple built of living stone, founded of the apostles, with Jesus Christ its cornerstone. The church is exalted, as it is said on the mountain, a beacon to the whole world, bringing bright with the glory of the Lamb, and echoing the Lord's of her saints. Lord, send your spirit from heaven to make this church an ever holy place, and this altar a ready table for the sacrifice of Christ. Here, may the waters of baptism overwhelm the shame of sin. Here, may your people die to sin and live again through the grace as your children. Here, your children gather around your altar, celebrate the memorial of the Paschal Lamb, and be fed at the table of Christ's word and Christ's body. Here, may prayer, the church banquet, resound through heaven and earth, as a plea for the world's salvation. Here, may the poor find justice, the victim of oppression, through freedom. From here, may the whole world, clothed in the dignity of the children of God, enter with gladness your city of peace. We ask you this, O Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, and in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Express in visible signs several aspects of the invisible work that the Lord accomplishes through the Church in its celebration of the divine mysteries, especially the Eucharist. The anointing with cleansing makes the altar a symbol of Christ, who before all others is and is called the Anointed One, for the Father anointed him with the Holy Spirit and constituted him the High Priest. The authority of the Church signifies that it is given over entirely and perpetually to Christian worship. Incense is burned in the altar to signify that Christ's sacrifice, there perpetrated in mystery, ascends to God as an odor of sweetness, and also to signify that the people's prayer rises up pleasing and acceptable, reaching the throne of God. The covering of the altar indicates that the Christian altar is the altar of the Eucharistic sacrifice and the table of the Lord, around which priests and people, by one and the same rite but with a difference of function, celebrate the memorial of Christ's death and resurrection and partake of his prayer, of his supper. The lighting of the altar, which is followed by the lighting of the church, reminds us that Christ is alive in lighting the nations. His brightness shines out in the church and through it in the whole human family.
In our mind, this altar and this building, God is power to make them holy, visible signs of mystery of Christ and the church.
Thank you.
altar and the oratory.
Lord, your prayer silence and incensing your sight, as this building is filled with fragrance, and your church is filled the word with the fragrance of Christ.
Through.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and thanks for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Lord, accept the gifts of your rejoicing church. May your people who are gathered in this sacred place arrive at eternal salvation through the mysteries in which we share. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift your heart to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Father, most holy, we have made the whole world thankful of your glory, that your name might everywhere be extolled, yet you allow us to consecrate to you places for divine mysteries, and so we dedicate joyfully to your majesty this house of prayer built by human labor. Here is foreshadowed the mystery of the true temple. Here is prefigured the heaven of Jerusalem, where you made the body of your son born of the tender virgin, the temple consecrated to you in which the fullness of the Godhead might dwell. You also established the church as a holy city, built upon the foundation of the apostles, with Christ Jesus himself, the chief cornerstone, as if it had been bold to develop of a chosen stone, given life to the Spirit and bounded by charity, where for endless ages you will be all in all, and the light of Christ will shine and dim forever. Through Christ, through him, O Lord, with all the angels and the saints, we give you thanks. As in exaltation, we acclaim. The blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
With your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Francis of Assisi, St. Clare of Assisi, St. Anthony of Padua, and with all the saints in its constant intercession, in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and in charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and John our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family. We dedicate this church to you. May it be for your family a house of salvation and place for the celebration of your heavenly sacraments. Here may the gospel of peace resound and the sacred mysteries be celebrated, so that your faithful, formed by the word of life and by divine grace, on their pilgrim way through the earthly city, may merit to reach the eternal Jerusalem. There, in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, after passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
We dare to say.
Amen.
grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we always free from sin and save all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
Yolanda or Haiyan struck here in central Philippines, the custody, the province, and the general curia in Rome appealed for assistance. So we received overwhelming response in the weeks and even in the months that followed, And so we reserve a round of applause after we finish the reading of all the donors. We'll clap our hands afterwards para hiling kayo dugay. So they are the following. First, we thank the different Franciscan provinces, especially the provinces of North America and Europe, where the bulk of the funds for the reconstruction and rehabilitation comes from these provinces, and whose donations arrive and are coursed through the OFM General Curia in Rome. We are grateful for these OFM provinces. We thank also the private groups and individuals who shared a substantial amount from their own pockets, both here and in the Philippines, here in the Philippines and abroad, and there are too many to mention. And of course, we thank for the intercession of the proper saints of the order, St. Francis and St. Clare of Assisi, as well as St. Anthony of Padua, of course, including the Most Holy Mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Now we thank the people around us. So first, we thank Bishop John Forrosuelo, Doctor of Divinity, the Archbishop of Palo, for the officiating of this dedication and consecration of this chapel. So for his untiring support, also you have listened to his homily to remember always the poor in the peripheries in this year of the poor, and in memory of Father Jerome Angulo OFM. He is my classmate, and he is instrumental for the land donation, this land here, in memory of Melchor Lara Zabal, who is the donor survived by his wife, Rita Lara Zabal, and children. Are they here? Okay, so we thank them. And also we thank those who supported the Franciscans Live Concert Sponsors. There was a series of concerts.